Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the India Today Group, I am delighted to welcome you all to the 5th Mail Today Tourism Summit. Recent FICCI Yes Bank report said that the tourism sector generated about $16.9 lakh crore in 2018 alone, making a growth about 6.7%. It is estimated, and these are optimistic estimates, that by 2029, the Indian tourism sector is likely to grow at an average of 6.7% per annum to reach $35 lakh crore. And Suman, we look forward to your comments and initial remarks, and then we'll have a conversation and hopefully open up this for question and answers. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Raj, ladies and gentlemen, good morning to all of you. So one good way to look is always to see how the world is looking at us. You know, in the year 2017, the World Economic Forum comes out with something called the Travel and Tourism Competitiveness Index. And in that, we had spectacularly jumped at 25 ranks. We were at 65, we jumped to 40. So clearly there were some things that we had done which warranted that change in our position. Recently, the World Travel and Tourism Council, the global body, has issued, it comes out with something called the Power and Performance Index, in which countries are ranked on their tourism performance. So typically what this means is that the Power and Performance Index broadly rates countries on four parameters. What is the contribution that tourism makes to your GDP in absolute terms? What is the amount of money that a foreign tourist is spending in India, which is visitor exports? What is the amount of money that your domestic tourist is spending in India? And what is the investment that is coming into the country? And there's a big jump there too. And India has emerged at the third position, behind only China and the United States of India. So simply put, what it means is that these are the countries that are driving the growth of the tourism sector across the world. I think there are three things that we have to, we have to get it done. The first is that we will have to moderate the rate of GST. Because, all of our competing countries are in single digits. The second issue that we will have to do is to get the infrastructure status for investments in the hospitality industry. Because currently you're not real estate, you're not infrastructure, so we are typically falling between two stools. So the demand side is strong, it is robust, it is growing rapidly, but the supply side is not keeping up. And my third and last point that we need to do is I think we need to market aggressively. I thank you all for your patience here.
Today we're going to talk about travel. So what is it that makes you go after this? What, despite all this tremendous activity, how does travel fit into your agenda?
I think for me, travel does three things. It's travel I use for de-stressing, for quality time with loved ones, and for learning. And I apply these three takeaways, these three takeaways are my goals from any kind of travel, including but not limited to work travel.
And when you go out to travel, what's the kind of place you choose? I mean, you probably have this whole itinerary, including the world. Where do you sort of pick your spots on this?
Well, ideally, something that interests me and interests the loved ones. So every travel will have an agenda. So if it's quality time with family, we'll choose a place in the mountains, Himachal, Uttarakhand, ideally, because it's accessible for us out of Delhi and Chandigarh, to spend time with family so that mobile phones don't get in the way, because fortunately, network is still a problem in the mountains. And when you have mobile phones, there's no quality time. So we try and make sure that we do a camping trip every single year.
What are the things that you think we do well in India, and what do you think we need to do better? I'm being very positive in that.
Oh, I have only positive feedback. I think every single state tourism board is doing exemplary stuff with regards to promoting tourism, whether it's wonderful ads that you get to see which target the right TG. I would like to see more targeted reach outs from respective state tourism boards. For example, I think there exists a very, very strong case both in Uttarakhand and Himachal and, of course, J&K to seek out adventurers who would say want to ski, do snowmobiling, or to do trekking and hiking. Now, I think that is a completely different TG from somebody who's just going to, you know, regularly to explore a new area in the city. But I feel within domestic travelers, there is opportunity to exploit subsets and mm-hmm. create subsets. So do behavior modification and create new target groups within the existing traveler sets.
We've had the global players come in, the booking.coms of the world, Airbnb coming in. But one of the initial pioneers in India was Make My Trip along with Yatra in the late 90s. So maybe you can talk a little about the evolution of this industry over the last 20 years or so.
Yeah, it's been actually an incredible journey over 2 decades now. You know, the real estate, the screen that consumer was looking at, which was like a big laptop or a desktop screen, that changed to a very small screen, which was a smartphone screen. And that toy became really, really powerful. You know, the multinational players, whether it is Airbnb and Booking.com and all, I think there's place for everyone. But long-term outlook remains very, very robust.
Michael's company is, you know, their target audience seems to be a younger demographic, if I may say. And tell us a little about the millennial traveler, Michael.
As a millennial traveler, you're always looking for unique experiences, authentic experiences. And as travel is becoming more and more social, people want to connect with locals, they want to connect with people around the world, like like-minded travelers around the world. So we pass on that information to our customers, to our service providers, and they create those experiences for them and basically showcase their portfolio of products to an engaged audience looking to travel.
Mr. Soin, do the people actually are willing to pay a little bit extra to have sustainable and responsible tourism?
I would say, in general, this used to be a debate about, you know, even 20 years ago, when the whole concept of tailor-made holidays and doing something for the environment was coming. And at that point, you said that you would take certain actions which might actually cost a little more. So would the customer be willing to pay more? So there was a large section of people who were indeed willing to pay that little more. A time has come where, you know, it's a given that you have to do responsible travel actions.
What would you like the finance minister to give to the travel industry in this budget?
For the ministry to obviously promote India in a more efficacious and efficient manner so that more inbound tourists, you know, come into India. I think there's a large potential, there's a large opportunity for innovation in the way we project India on global platforms and at forums. And I think we've seen very, very healthy growth over the last few years in the number of people coming into India.
Manoj, आपने शीला जी को 3,60,000 वोटों से हराया तो इस जीत के बारे में क्या कहना आप?
देखिए, ये कहना कि मैंने शीला दीक्षित को हराया, ये शायद पूरी तरह से सच नहीं होगा. हम उस पॉलिसी को हराना चाहते हैं जो कहता है कि हम देशद्रोहियों के साथ हैं, हम देशद्रोह का कानून समाप्त कर देंगे. हम उसको हराना चाहते हैं. अगर केवल शीला दीक्षित जी को हराने की बात हो तो शायद वो थोड़ी भावना कमजोर हो जाएगी.
तिवारी जी, एक लड़ाई आपने जीत ली, दूसरी बार जीत ली, 2014 में भी जीता आपने, इस बार भी जीता. अब एक आगे लड़ाई है फरवरी 2020 में, दिल्ली का विधानसभा चुनाव है और आप दिल्ली बीजेपी के अध्यक्ष भी हैं, तो क्या स्ट्रैटजी है, क्या रणनीति है आपकी 2020 के लिए?
हाँ, अब चूंकि आपने खाली शीला जी पे ले लिया, मैं वहीं रह गया. वरना तो हमारी लड़ाई तो मुख्यतः इस दिल्ली को एक ऐसी सोच से मुक्त कराने की है जो कि हर काम में अड़ंगा डालते हैं और रोक करके बोलते हैं प्रधानमंत्री नहीं करने दे रहे. मेरी दोनों हाथ जोड़ करके प्रार्थना है, मोदी जी प्रधानमंत्री का शपथ ले लिए, 1-5 साल के लिए दिल्ली हमें दिल्ली के लोग दे दें. अगले फरवरी में हम 5 साल में इतनी बात ही नहीं करनी पड़ेगी. वी विल मेक डिफरेंस और वो बीजेपी करके दिखाएगी.
दिल्ली देश की राजधानी है, जो भी पर्यटन आते हैं वो पहले दिल्ली में जाते, फिर आगरा जाते, फिर अलग अलग जगह जाते. सो दिल्ली में टूरिज्म के लिए आपका क्या विजन है, क्या होना चाहिए बीइंग ए नेशनल कैपिटल?
दिल्ली को 2 टूरिज्म के स्पॉट पॉइंट से देखना चाहिए. एक तो वो जो हिस्टोरिक प्लेसेस हैं जहाँ पर कि लोग बड़ी संख्या में आते हैं, कई कई जो तो मॉन्यूमेंट्स टूट रहे थे, हमने उसको ठीक उन्हीं पत्थरों के रंग का, उन्हीं के तरीके का उसको फिर से बनाना शुरू किया और लोगों को कई जगह हम वो लाइट एंड साउंड से भी उसकी हिस्ट्री बता रहे हैं. मैं समय कभी गया था इसी स्तर पर देखने सिंगापुर, मैंने सेंटोसा देखा, दुनिया भर के लोग सेंटोसा देखने आ रहे हैं, रिक्लेम करके समुद्र की जगह को उन्होंने बना दिया, बड़ा बड़ा जहाज घर के आगे उतर रहा है, और हमारे पास इतनी बड़ी यमुना जी हैं, हम भी तो सेंटोसा के तर्ज पे जमनोसा बना सकते हैं। सोचे तो, विजन तो लाए।
दिल्ली के पास पोटेंशियल है, जैसा आपने कहा यमुना नदी है हमारे पास, क्या हम एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं कि बीजेपी के 2020 मैनिफेस्टो में, बीजेपी दिल्ली के 2020 मैनिफेस्टो में यमुना टूरिज्म होगा?
मैंने तो कह दिया यमनोसा, यमुना नहीं, यमनोसा शब्द आप याद कर लें, हमने बहुत सोच समझ के रखा है। हमें दिल्ली को एक ऐसा यमनोसा देना है कि पूरा दुनिया उस पर गर्व करेगी, और मेल टुडे का ये जो कंक्लेव है वो यादगार रहेगा उसके लिए।
In Kashmir, Mr. Bakshi, they are opening up new areas because the Pahalgam, Gulmarg and Srinagar people are familiar with. You're kind of cutting down on these destinations a little to have sustainable tourism and opening up new areas in Kashmir open to tourists. Please tell us a little more about it.
Ashish, the thing is, we are opening up new destinations just to take the footfall of our old destinations like Pahalgam, Gulmarg, which everybody knows. If I ask 80% of the people, Hanji, Pahalgam gaye the. Gulmarg gaye the, but nobody knows of Bhotpatri, Yusmarg, or some places in Ladakh or some places in Jammu. They are equally brilliant. The water flows there also. Yes, there was no infrastructure there. The quality of infrastructure now has to be improved. Natural water disposal, anything, it has to be worked out before we start opening up a new destination.
Mr. Bhagat, now you're opening up whitewater rafting in certain areas. Tell us a little about that.
First, we started it in Akhnoor, which is just 22 kilometers away from Jammu itself. That now we have started doing these kinds of water rafting also in other areas as well. One, we started in Riyasi, District Riyasi. It is just 84 kilometers away from Jammu and is on the way from Katra to Shivkhodi. There we used to conduct a white water rafting championship in the month of March every year.
How you manage the success story in wildlife conservation in Gir and how you involve the local community there apart from the government's efforts?
Gir Sanctuary is the last abode of the lions in free living condition. It's not only the government or the tourist who have played a very active role, but it is also the local people, the Maldaris who live in the forest. They are our eyes and ears. They are the shepherds. And they see to it that no poaching takes place. And they're also, when they find an animal sick, they tell us.
Let's start the discussion with maybe Rehan. Let's take it to you first. And let's ask you that you've been a competitive swimmer, as well as you shared with me that golfing is your new passion. So do share with us your experiences in both these spaces.
So in terms of my own personal experiences, when I've had the privilege of being invited to different destinations, what the hotels or properties of these places have done is they've made sure they had tie-ups with different golf courses around that area where I could get to go and play at. An Indian consumer, when he's traveling for a luxurious experience, there's a certain level of luxury that he expects anyway. But what really sets it apart are these distinctive experiences and memories that you can carry back.
So Waseem, I'm going to take this conversation to you. What do you think the trend is and how does it define the luxury market?
These days when we are talking about luxury, people or millennials or young, I feel not only the youth, but everyone today are wanting to invest in instead of tangible properties, they are going into experiences. So if we are talking about experiences and luxury, it's exclusivity that people want. Someone wants is exclusivity. It's not that they are overspending. They want everything that they are spending on. They would not overspend on anything. They would expect you to give them what they want. No one wants to compromise on luxury or for that matter, experience.
Rajni ma'am, I'm going to take this to you. Do share what would luxury on a train mean and how is India taking that forward?
There has been consistent growth in the booking of Maharajas Express. People would like to travel slow. They want to enjoy their life, fine dining experiences, good cutlery, good crockery, good offboard experiences. Everything is taken well, visit to palaces, interaction with the royal community. All they are looking for, then coming and sleeping. Their sleep has to be good, their pillow has to be good. Everything has to be of the ultimate quality, which luxury means. Luxury doesn't mean a tagging a price to someone. No, that those days are gone. Value for the service has to be brought in. So the slow travel and the comfortable travel is now percolating in the industry, and the bookings for the longer journeys are also coming up.
Dennis, I'm going to take this to you. Do share, what do you think is going on in the luxury market right now, and where does India stand in that space?
From a consumer point of view, a lot of us are seeking experiences, as all the panelists said. But why are we seeking those experiences? The experiences may be 10 days, 20 days. We need to go deeper because we are seeking great memories. And all of us on the panel then are in the management of those memories. So when you're looking at luxury, you're actually looking at the management of memories. And that is the emotional connect you need to build. So it's an exciting time where you need to understand the psychology of luxury and then deliver on that promise.
I'm going to start with Manish.
Food is a necessity of life. And for Indians, for many years traveling abroad, food was the major hindrance or hurdle for them traveling abroad. But now that is changing. And world over, Indians are traveling, and famous chefs, big restaurants, are now curating menus which is suitable for our palate.
So do you think Indians, who are seen traditionally as bargain seekers, are now beginning to indulge in shopping, in luxury shopping, personal concierges, curated experiences, limited editions, are all these defining the new Indian traveler?
I would say world has changed a lot. But like my team went and found some of the vintage clothing places which have got some of the most amazing patterns and pieces which are made in 1960s and 70s. To be able to find these kind of small little spaces to shop things in Paris which are very authentic. They are very, very clever about it. The kind of food experience they can't get in India, they will indulge into that. So in the same way, they do not go and shop at Zara. They do not go and shop at a place or a kind of garment which is any which available in India. It's almost like excess baggage for them. So they end up picking up, they're being very, very smart about how they want to spend their money.
How important is travel style for Indians today?
I think it's always been important. It's just that there were no options earlier. They are available now. Yes, now people, when they come to us and they say, hey, I'm traveling, do I need something special? I'd say, no, this is what you wear today. And this is what same thing you wear then. It's just that you tuck it out, for example, if it's a shirt. So it's also subtle styling tips and techniques you tell them.
Anupama, what you wear and what you experience in a local destination, please help us understand the connect.
The whole idea of a holiday is a mind space. It's not the physical time you've taken, it's not the location, it's the actual, if I may use the word, transformation. And we must use everything that even the concept of a holiday has to offer. We've all come a long way. We want the escapism, we want to, like Sukhet said, wear things that we don't wear here, because it adds a dimension to us, isn't it? The most important thing is it takes us out of our comfort zone, makes us braver, and makes the holiday that much sexier.
Sonam, we are here on a travel conclave. Share with us, what do you feel social media is a positive or a negative? And has it helped you spread your message?
I've always maintained that if you handle it responsibly and if you handle it properly, then it can have many positives to it. I try to use my social media as responsibly as I can. Since we are on the topic of conserving the nature, I do my own bit, whether it's planting a tree or saying no to plastic. Even if I can influence one person's mind, then why not? So yes, if you use it properly, then social media can be very helpful. And I think personally in my case, I have been able to do it in my own small way.
When you're on a holiday, what are the things that you look for and what are the things that you like to do?
For me, the most important thing is to know the people of the place, the culture of that place, the history of that place. So I'm a very curious person, and for me, these things are very, very important. That's why I always prefer to choose destinations that have some history to it. And to experience the local cuisines.
What would be your dream destinations? Three, pick three that you really want to go to.
Antarctica is on my...
that's a good one.
It's definitely on my one of my top three. The second is Japan. I haven't been. And it's a very, like, I've heard that it's a different world altogether. It's almost like you're in a video game. It's very advanced. And the third... I want to go to Afghanistan.
Oh, that's an interesting choice.
I would love to go to Afghanistan. I've never been.